quick food.
Oh, there's another one. There's another one.
He's coming back. He's coming back. He's angry. He's angry. Watch, I let him.
Let him get like a quick pass by.
Yeah.
For the ego.
What's cool about that McLaren? That the driver's young. Because a lot of the times you see these supercars and then you look in the mirror, in the window, and you see who's driving it, and it's some fucking old guy. And it's, you know, it's whatever, like, you know, we're all getting fucking older, but it makes me happy to see another fellow young gangster driving a nice supercar, because it communicates that you don't have to be 65, 70, 80 years old and wait till you fucking retire for you to live the life that you want. That's that.
What's up, guys? So I was in the area and I had a listing presentation at this property, right? Which I am obviously going to get because I'm here doing a completely unexpected marketing video that I'm going to send to my clients just so that they know the kind of work that they would expect when they're working with the REJ team. So I got my drone out. My guy Vinny over here is making me look good, obviously. We already took a promotional video and now we're gonna get just some quick videos of the house. The reason why I like doing this is because I wanna show my clients that we do the extra mile to earn their respect, to earn their business, and obviously to earn their trust. So here we go. Well, flying this thing is a fucking challenge because I don't fly fucking drones, but when you're a real estate agent, you really have to be a fucking jack of all trades. Gotta be able to do everything. Fucking fly planes and sell houses. There we go. Got it on video mode. Yeah, you gotta be careful with these trees, man. Bro, look at this.
Oh, you can't look down?
Yeah, I could look down, but I don't want to look down. I want to get on the other side right now. So I got to be careful, because if I fucking crash into a tree, I'm fucked. Let's go get that. So we just crashed, but I'm pretty sure I got my angles. See, you gotta push it to the limit. You gotta go as far as you can, because then that's the only way that you'll know your true potential. Now, where the hell did this thing fall? You can see it? Hold this.
Go around.
Pretty sure it wasn't that bad. No. Behind the scenes. Okay. We're good. And it looks like it's in good shape too, man. Nice. Oh yeah. All right. Let's get out of here. I think we got some good shots. Let's get that box. All right, mission complete.
So what do you think about those Audi Chargers?
Man, these Audi Chargers, okay. I love Audi, don't get me wrong. I don't have any complaints about Audi except for one fucking thing. And it's not even Audi, because I've heard from a Volkswagen owner. Not going to disclose who it is, but you know who the fuck you are. You know who you are. That we have the same fucking issue with these chargers. So, obviously it has Apple CarPlay and whatever. So, when you connect it to the phone, that's the way to get Apple CarPlay with a 2019 Audi and the ones previous to this one, right? Because I know that in the new ones, you could do the Bluetooth shit, whatever. So, there's something wrong with this outlet because it eats up the chargers. Like, they only work for a few days and then it just completely doesn't work. It's obsolete after that. You plug it into your phone and it just, look, charging. But then you move it a little bit and it disconnects right away. So I don't know what's wrong with these chargers, man. We got to get in touch with Volkswagen because they got to fix these outlets, bro. There's no way that I'm going to just keep spending all of my commission money on iPhone chargers. I don't work for iPhone chargers. This is not the deal, okay? So if you work at Volkswagen or Audi and you're listening to this, fucking fix these outlets, bro.
Later.
Cakes look amazing.
Do you like it
steamed
or roasted?
I'll do a
boost.
Yeah. And we're ready to order whenever the wait.
Yep.
Oh, it's you?
Oh, perfect. Yeah. Wow, nice, look at that.
Yeah.
I'm going to get the chicken parm with penne.
Okay.
I'll do the grilled chicken penne vodka.
Okay.
You see that? We are so effective and efficient. Even before we sat down, we already had ordered our food. Who else is doing that? Us. Because time is valuable. It's not money. It's more valuable than money. We know that. So.
I know what we're going to do next time.
What are we going
to
do?
We're going to call them ahead. And we're going to be like, yeah, we're coming in to eat. So this is what we're going to have. You can start making it now.
Dude, we should just walk into the fucking chicken and start popping chicken legs in our fucking mouth. Bro. I think that's what we should do.
Taste of Italy.
Life is good when you can fucking eat what you want. I remember when I didn't have a choice, and now I do. You better hurry up. You can get a six pack and eat like me.
Kevin, surprise.
With proper care and attention, your humidor will give you many years of service. To help maintain your investment, follow these tips. I'm not going to read the tips. Well, I'm reading them in my head. Bro, that's just a box. Avoid placing objects on top of the humidor. What does it do? Bro, this is a high top of the notch, top of the top humidor. What does it do? It stores your cigars at a 70 degree Fahrenheit temperature. Where does the temperature come from?
It comes from the room.
Where? I don't see any vents in that box.
Exactly. You don't need any vents.
Bro, you got sold a fucking box with listen, a dream.
Bro, that's a fucking box.
This is very important. This is very important for you to learn. This is not just a box. Bro, they sold you a box and a dream. There's nothing in there.
It's a beautiful mahogany box.
But how does it keep the temperature, though?
It keeps it by keeping it shut. Bro, you got fucking scared. Listen, guys. You guys need to chill out and take direction.
Bro, this is literally just a box.
Mantello cigars.
What's the difference between this and that?
This is not that.
Let's inspect the box. Yeah, bro, I don't get it.
What do you mean you don't get it?
How does it...
We're gonna figure it out. Hold on.
Fill your humidifier with good quality propylene glycol distilled water solution. What is that?
That's your humidifier.
Oh, that's what it is.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Now we're See, now why we're didn't you say started. That?
Well, you guys just jumped the gun.
Do not overfill the humidifier. It should be wet, not soaking. Should be both, actually.
With the security guards.
Holy really? Shit.
Yeah. What happened?
The security guards beat the shit out some kid or some girl.
Some girl?
Something. You know?
I don't know.
What did you tell yourself?
I was like, no bars, no clubs for till I feel like I've earned a celebration.
So if you get a couple bullseyes, is that enough to earn a celebration? Now you said in any bars or clubs, but you didn't say anything about lounges or rooftops.
Justin, what do you think about that?
I'm just saying, like, it's not the same crowd.
It identifies as such.
I mean, listen, you want to be a sophisticated person, right? Sophisticated people don't go to clubs or bars, they go to lounges.
Yeah.
So we should go to a lounge.
All right. I may consider it.
He's considering.
Yeah. 6.5 hours later.
We're at the gun range right now, about to empty some clips, right? They're about to really feel me in here, if you feel what I'm saying. And I'm with the squad. I actually came here earlier by myself. And they were like, listen, we can't let you shoot a gun by yourself unless you bring your own ratchet. If you don't have your own ratchet on you, if you don't got that thing on you, and you want to rent it from us, you gotta have your squad with you. So the squad pulled up, and now we're ready to unload. And then we're gonna go out, get some bitches, and then unload again. That's what the night's about. Like 91 Dan Marino, I swear this guy Michael Rapino's boosting my ego. Overly focused is far from the time to rest now. Debates growing about who they think is the best now. Took a while, got the jokers out of the deck now. I'm holding all the cards and niggas wanna play. This is the
Glock 9. It's the real shit. This is the gun you carry when you're pumping gas. I'm authentic, real name, no gimmicks, no game, no scrimmage. I ain't playing with you niggas at all. My classmates, they went on to be chartered accountants or work with their parents. But thinking back on how they treated me, my high school reunion might be worth an appearance. Make everybody have to go through security. So I aimed for the A. I aimed for the A. And as you can see,
well, those were all my bullets, bro.
I let the paper do the talking.
All right,
I let the paper do the talking.
So you like the AR?
The AR is my favorite assault rifle. There's nothing that goes against it. I mean, the AK is pretty nice.
Yeah.
But I like the AR. I think the AR is better.
The AR-15 is much better.
What do you think? The AK or the AR?
Bro, the AR-15 by far.
What is this one called? The other assault?
I don't know. They call it a bullpup though. That's the style. That's
yeah.
Not
the name, nah. The AR, when I was aiming at the sight, it just felt cleaner, a lot smoother. Even the recoil shot, it just didn't jump as much. Accurate with it, so it's definitely the best assault rifle to have. Like, if he's gonna buy an assault rifle, which I already have, I'm gonna buy one again, and it was gonna be my first assault rifle. It would definitely be the AR,
yeah,
for sure.
Now we're shooting the SIG P365, one of my favorite pistols.
Cut this part out.
That's what happens when you're a Tesla.
Yeah, how'd you do this?
See? You should have got a gas car, bro.
So this is like the mag. So. Oh, okay.
Put one in first, let go.
Oh, okay.
What are you going for?
This one and this one. All right, let's see.
Yeah.
We
only
let's
got
see.
One shot there.
That's the one. I'm going to send it back to 40.
Nah.
Yeah, bro.
Too far.
Bro, if somebody's attacking you and you guys shoot from that far, you better practice.
Let's see.
Alright, these three. 10 yards.
What happened here?
Bro, don't worry about that one.
Alright.
3 hours later.
So we just finished shooting some
guns at the gun range. And the best way to finish off the night is to go grab some steaks at Catch Steakhouse.
Boom. Go. Oh shit. So what happened?
They just fucking crashed over here. How interesting. All right, we're here. Justin and Kevin are here.
Perfect, let's go.
3 minutes to spare.
Entrance.
Love the hat, bro.
How's it going?
Good, all right.
How are you?
How's it going, sir?
The catch is, when you're digging from the garbage, it's not that expensive to put garbage food on the fucking stove and then in the oven and then in a box. That's what you're paying for. That's the $40. But, yes, of course, my brother. But here's the difference. When you're at one of the most prestigious steakhouses in New York City, they have a farm in the kitchen where they kill the cows, and you can go see them right now. They let you walk in and look at the cow that you're eating before they slaughter it. You get to kill it, you get to name it, whatever you want to do, okay? And then that ends up ending in your plate somehow, and then you eat it, and that's why you're paying $60 to $90 for a piece of steak, okay? That's the difference.
Boom.
We're talking about GMO and organic, you know? Kosher, non-kosher. Bullshit and halal.
Oh,
right?
Shit.
That truck and Mrs. DWB. Yo, listen.
A lady in the front desk is in a very bad mood. If I don't make her smile before I leave, Kevin agreed that we're going to top.
No, I did not. I did not agree to that.
Yes.
Bro, you agreed with that, bro.
No,
cheers.
I didn't.
Cheers. Cheers.
You want to see? You're outvoted. We're going to fucking Tao. Yeah, you're.
And if we don't go to Tao, we're going to go to PhD. Yep. Yep.
Let me tell you something, okay? Yes, they did take a little bit of time. Well, a lot of fucking time for the food to get here. But I will tell you that the steak is fucking good.
Oh.
And perfection takes time.
Good things take time.
Listen. I'm drinking a cappuccino right now. And I heard a famous saying, anything is possible. So I got some Henny in this cup. I'm gonna mix it up with this cappuccino. Okay?
Shit.
All right. Now, I don't know how this is gonna taste, but I know it's gonna be good.
Christian, is it gonna be good?
Who here? Listen, hold on. Who here has had Henny with coffee? By the show of hands.
I had alcohol.
Nah.
Henny, I had alcohol.
Nah. None of you guys. Really? You mixed it with the
coffee. You can tell the Jose was the one that ordered a drink. Okay.
So Justin knows. But if you haven't had Henny with coffee, you're fucking missing out.
This is a human drink.
That's you. Cheers.
Mission accomplished. Steak is in the stomach. Now it's time to go out and conquer the night.
Tables turn, bridges burn, you live and learn. With the ink, I could murder word of my nigga Irv. Yeah, I swear shit just started clicking, dog. You know it's real when you are who you think you are.